She's here in studio. A Portland woman is the first person to complete 6 World Marathon Majors with a spinal cord injury on her foot. Now, Wendy Garrett started running about 3.5 years after she had an accident. That's what's crazy to me. And she's been with us before. She's our 8th hero today, and she's live on the couch. How are you feeling? Are you tired?
I'm not. I'm finally over jet lag and ready to go.
Ready to do it.
So tell us about the Tokyo experience.
Tokyo was amazing just because it was awesome just to be there and run the marathon, and every marathon's emotional, but for it to be the 6th one of my 6th was, it was just a very special experience and brought up all of the, you know, past emotions, everything I went through, so it was a great experience.
Take us back to that. So what did you go through exactly, and what really got you to start running?
Yeah, I was active my whole life. I was a competitive gymnast. After that, I got into running just as something to stay in shape, and I coached gymnastics, which took me all over eventually to Bermuda. That's where I had an accident and lost the use of my left leg. And that took 3 years to finally get medical answers. I was in a medical walking boot for 3 years. My life was on hold. I wasn't working. I wasn't running. I wasn't doing anything.
And no one thought you'd run again.
Yeah, really? My whole life was kind of questionable. So I just wanted to be able to walk normal.
Let alone run marathons.
Yeah. So finally, I found a doctor that had answers. That was 2 different spinal cord injuries. He sent me to be fitted for an orthotic brace. And I asked the doctor, I'm like, will I run again? And he kind of said, let's just try walking first and see what happens. But the day I got my brace, I went home and went for a run, called my mom crying, and then I just added a mile a week and then just built up.
Went up from there.
Wow. Yeah.
Wow. What's next? Oh, you must have something else amazing coming up.
I do. So my next, I have the Boston Marathon a month from today. And then now there is a challenge to run the 7 continents. So I've done 3. Wow. So I figure might as well go. So I'm going to go to Medellin, Colombia in the fall and check off my 4th continent.
Girl,
so.
You're a little nuts. I mean, this is getting a little crazy.
I love how she says it. She's so nonchalant. Yeah. Oh, just the Boston.
And I hope you don't mind me asking, but how do you finance this?
I have the best village. It takes a village, and I have the best support system. I receive a grant through the Challenge Athletes Foundation each year, and then I save my pennies. I work hard, but I have tons of friends that have, you know, supported my fundraising, donations. I just have the best village, so none of this would be possible without them.
Do you speak? Is there I'm thinking you should be a motivational speaker. Do you do that as well?
I have a couple things set up. I'm hoping to kind of get into that and just be able to share my story and hopefully help other people.
I tell you who she's motivating is she teaches gymnastics to young students.
Oh, wow.
And
they always
just look at you and go, I can do anything Wendy can.
Yeah.
Well, you make me bad for being me. I can tell you
No.
that.
No.
Real quickly, do you have a favorite of all-time race or one that you really did not like?
I loved them all. Each one kind of had a different story, involved with it. But of course, Boston's amazing because that's kind of it's just special. That's the Olympics of, for the everyday runner. And I've really liked them all. So each one just had a different experience.
Keep us posted on your progress.
Yeah, absolutely.
Thank you.
Nice to see you again, Wendy.
Thank you.
Very inspiring.